Now, one interesting development with regard to Islam in South Asia, which you don't have in Africa, is because Islam confronted caste system in India. In the case of Africa, it was the tribalism of the Africans and how Islam tried to create an overarching loyalty for these different tribal groups. In the case of India, people have to now evolve Islamically to accept a non-caste society. And of course, just like in Africa, where many of the Africans struggle and are still struggling to transcend their tribalism, in the case of India, many Muslims have and had and continue to struggle to transcend caste, because that was part of the old order before Islam. And of course, this led to the leveling of these societies. The coming of Islam led to the leveling of these societies, because the majority of the people who became Muslim in India and now Pakistan or Bangladesh came out of a Hindu background. Of course, a very small minority came out of a Buddhist background, because Buddhism came out of India, but it didn't have a foothold in India. In fact, Buddhism became more successful. This is one thing Christianity and Buddhism have in common. They are the only two world religions, the birthplace of whose founding father they don't control. So, I mean, you know, like, this is one thing that Buddha was an Indian, but he's more influential now among Chinese and other Asian groups than Indians. You see what I'm saying? Just like Christ. If you go to the Middle East, they are more Jewish and Muslim. Christians are very small in number now in the birthplace of Jesus. So that is one thing Buddha and Christ have in common, in the sense that the people, they have followers outside of their people. The people who should have been following Christ would be Arabs and Jews, because they are Semites, but they are not. The same thing with the Buddhists. The Buddhists are not Indians. There are very few Indians who are Buddhists. You see what I'm saying? These are things we don't want to talk about. You know, like, these are realities that exist in world history. People don't want to deal with these realities, but this is history. So, I mean, you know, like, so when you look at reality in India, you will see that the coming of Islam in India changed the psychology of the Indian Muslims. That's one reason why Indian Muslims, even though they are a minority, they have a superiority complex vis-a-vis the Hindus. No, they do. They will not admit that, but they do. She admits that. They don't want to admit. It is human nature. I mean, the Muslim Indians, they're very small compared to this Hindu, but they still feel superior to them. Hey, you guys, who are you guys? So, I mean, that's the psychology, you see, that exists. Because Islam created that feeling in them that we received the last telephone number from God. You see what I'm saying? I mean, you know, because that's what Islam is. I mean, you know, like, jokingly, you know, I always tell people that they play this supersessionist game. You know, that's what we call theologically, we call it supersessionism. I mean, one religion claims to be superior to the other because of the recency of its message. We received the message more recently. Americans know that because they change their numbers in their lifetime. So their best friends are the ones who have their telephone numbers. So jokingly, when we go to interfaith dialogue, I always tell people that when we play the supersessionist game on each other, we are really playing a game I call the AT&T game. Because you see, if you claim that God gave you an 800 number, you just want 800 Judaism, you get through. Now when you come and tell me you guys have the Old Testament and we have the New Testament, you're telling me that you have the latest number. So, I mean, you know, like, so you're telling me that if I dial my old number, which worked for me all these years, by your logic, you are saying the angels are going to say the number you're dialing is not in service. Check the New Testament or the Quran for the latest. That happened in India with the Muslims, because those Muslims, you know, who now live in Pakistan, India, the Africans play the same game with their own tribal Africans who are not Muslims, that we got the latest message from God, because that's the Quran. And of course, that creates a sense of superiority. And of course, that works in the psychology, because you feel, hey, yeah, we received the latest message from God. And of course, this message is egalitarian. It centers on justice. And it affects the history of Islam in India. And it affects the consciousness of Muslims in India and other parts of South Asia.